using this crochet needle, which is a size 6 millimeter by Clover. And I'm using different colors of yarn, which is medium weight yarn. Usually this yarn is suitable for a crochet needle of 4 millimeter, but I'm using a larger hook, and in this pattern you need to crochet a little loose. So I've made a foundation chain of 82, and now I'm going to close the chain with a slip stitch. I'm going to the first stitch. Be sure your chain isn't twisted. So this is my first chain. I will insert yarn over and pull through two loops. And now I will make the first row. I will chain one. I will make a single crochet on each chain. And I will insert yarn over, pull up the yarn, yarn over and pull through two. So in the next, insert, pull up the yarn, yarn over and pull through two. And this is how I work on each chain. I've made 41 single crochet and I'm halfway, and now I will chain one and I will continue making one double crochet, but on top of the chain one I will put a stitch marker. So this is my chain. Insert the stitch marker and continue making one single crochet on each chain. Row one. Again, I've made 41 single crochet stitches and now I will chain one. And I will turn to the new color. I will insert. And I will grab my green yarn, pull it over, and pull through two loops. Pull the yarn over and pull through. And on this chain one, which I've made in the end of first row, I will put a stitch marker. I will chain two, one and two. And on the first stitch, I will make a single crochet. And now chain one, skip the next stitch, and on this stitch, one single crochet. Chain one, skip one stitch, and one single crochet. Repeat this in row two. So chain one, skip one, and one single crochet. I arrived at the part where I put the stitch marker. I've made one chain, and I will make one single crochet on this stitch before the chain one of the previous row, and now I will remove the stitch marker and in this part where I've made the chain in the previous row, I will make two single crochet, one and two, chain two, one and two, and in the same space, two more single crochet, one and two. Now make one single crochet on the next stitch. And I will put the stitch marker in the middle on top of the chain two. And now continue, chain one, skip one, and make one single crochet. Chain one, skip one, and one single crochet. Now, on the next stitch marker in the end of the row, you will do the same.
The row.
In this last stitch, I will make one single crochet. And I arrived at the stitch marker, I'll remove it, and in this space I will make two single crochet, one and two, and chain two, one, two, and in the same space two single crochet, one and two. I will start with row three. I will end in the second chain of the beginning, grab my new color, which I take a gray color, and pull it through the loops, yarn over, and pull through. And I will put the stitch marker on top of the chain tool. Like this. And now I will start with row three. I will make one single crochet in this first space. And chain one. And in the next space, in this part between those two single crochet, one single crochet, chain one, and in the next space, one single crochet, chain one, in the space, one single crochet, and repeat this in row three. I arrived at the part where I put the stitch marker. I will chain one, skip this last stitch, and in the next stitch make one single crochet, chain one, and remove the stitch marker, and in this place make two single crochet, one and two, chain two, one and two, and in the same space two single crochet. Now put the stitch marker back on the part where I've made the chain two. One. And on this stitch I will make a single crochet and chain one, skip one stitch, and in this space one single crochet, chain one, and in this next space one single crochet. So repeat this in this row, and at the end of the row, at this place of the stitch marker, you will make the same part as you did here. I'm now at the end of row three. You can count those single crochet stitches. On this side I have 22, and on this side I also have 22 between those corners. And now I will start with row 4. I will close this row with a slip stitch into the chain of the beginning, and I will grab my new color. I use a light blue, but you can pick any color you like. I will yarn over and pull through, yarn over and pull through. So this is the beginning, and chain one, and I will move over to the next space, and I will make a single crochet. So chain one and single crochet, chain one and single crochet. You will repeat this in each row. Well, I arrived at the corner again. I will chain one, skip one stitch, and on this stitch I will make one single crochet. And now at the space where I've put the stitch marker, and in this space I will make two single crochet, one and two, and chain two, one and two, and in the same space two single crochet, one and two. Now put the stitch marker back in the middle part. And on this first single crochet, I will make one single crochet, chain one, skip this stitch, and in this space make one single crochet, chain one, and repeat as in the previous row, on each space one single crochet. I'm at the end of the fourth row. On this last stitch I will make one single crochet, and I will close the row with a slip stitch into the second chain of the beginning. And now I will start with a new color, which is this mustard color. So I will yarn over, pull through, yarn over and pull through. So you make sure you have the same amount of stitches on each side. And I will repeat the pattern. In this first space, one single crochet, chain one. In the next space, a single crochet, chain one. And a single crochet. Now at the corner of the fifth row, I will chain one and skip one stitch, and in the next stitch make one single crochet, and in the corner, in the space, I will remove the stitch marker and make two single crochet, one and two, chain two, one and two, and in the same space two single crochet. And now put the stitch marker in the middle, just like that. One single crochet on the next stitch, chain one, and in the next space one single crochet, chain one, and one single crochet. So you will repeat this pattern until your poncho is large enough. But you keep in mind that on this side and on this side you have the equal amount of stitches. I now arrived at row 6, and in row 6 I will use a medium blue. So I will insert yarn over and pull through. So pull the old color, the mustard, so it will tighten, and yarn over and pull through. And now I will chain one and continue the pattern. So in the space, one single crochet and chain one and one single crochet. I'm now working on row 7, and in row 7 I use this pale pink. So I work the same stitches as in the previous row. I'm now working on row 8. In row 8 I use this beige brown color, which is the last color I use, and from this part on I will start again with the first color I started with, and then repeat all 8 colors each row. I've made a total of 48 rows, but of course you can make more rows to make a bigger size.